present my most ugly piece ever. So this is a piece I built. I noticed it's dated. I looked at it the other day. Still in daily use, 1968. First case piece ever made. Wasn't a shop class exactly, but something like that. Made out of pure mahogany. And the ideas and madness. It's in the barn now. It's got a mouse hole. It has repairs. It has a little toggle at the bottom because one time it held poisons to keep the kids out. All this cleaning solvents and that kind of thing in the house. But the interesting thing about it is, at that young age of a designer, where I wasn't thinking anything about design, by the way, as you can see, no details whatsoever, I was developing ideas that had followed through all the way in my career. And what are they specifically? First of all, it's an asymmetry. The two sides are not the same width of drawer, so to speak. You also have great graduated drawers from the top to the bottom. You also have handmade handles, as clunky as they are. Including, oh, this is a very nice, finely nailed construction. The mandatory dovetail shot with nails. And repairs over the years, one of the things that's been repaired is a knob off of a VW bus, emergency knob. So that's the emergency drawer. So that piece actually follows on this. Apropos of what Chris said, the Shakers used asymmetry, and I'm using asymmetry. This is a piece that is designed following some Shaker ideas, except for the fact that it's got a bowed facade, and it's got the asymmetrical arrangement of three small drawers over the next to the two larger drawers. And my design philosophy, worth giving you a minute of it, is that a piece such as this should really attract your attention across the room. And I think the wood does that. I think the simplicity of the form does that. Many things have been attracted to it. And as you get closer to it, you start to see the way the details relate to each other. You start to see exactly how the scale of the drawers are, the shapes, the edge details at the top, the under bevel, all those kinds of things that are important to my work still. But it's a third level that I'm most interested in some ways, and that is when you come up to this and you look at it really carefully. It might take you several weeks or a month or longer to realize that. You see the inlaid in the front of the little drawers, the two larger drawers rather, are blue glass buttons. That was the inspiration for the piece. I found the buttons and then decided what the recipe go with them. And the buttons having two little holes in them, I made two little brass tacks and put those in. So when you look at this, you get a little glint of blue. It's inlaid into black. And you get these little sparks of brass, almost like two little eyes looking in. It's that third level that I find is the most interesting, the little subtle edges and details that one discovers by living with a piece for a long time. And then I like to do a little surprise things. I doubt the Shakers ever did little secret drawers like this, but a little drawer coming out at the end, which they definitely did do, sort of just letting it have fun. So, I've been doing a lot of pieces you probably would expect if you've seen my work in the magazine for a long time. And several years ago, I started to explore more curvilinear three-legged forms. I don't know exactly why, but the evolution is that as a designer, as a maker, I like to continue learning things all the time, and this seemed like a logical place to start. I went back to some roots I had when I studied in Boston, do silver feet, I'll talk about that, that starts at the bottom, and saber legs, and this macassar ebony veneered shape with seven drawers. And being the playful person that I am, I decided to have a drawer come out of another drawer and try and solve that challenge. And it actually works very, very well as far as the two drawers are completely independent of each other. And to draw the piece together, let me just go forward here. Some silver toes on this piece, as well as little silver dots. And I believe that it's nice to have a certain palette of materials, as long as you don't go too overboard with it, and to use those in repeated ways, similar to a fugue, although I don't know much about music, I assume that's the way they are repeated forms, patterns. This is a piece I built last year. At this point, I'm doing more collaboration with my wife, who's a painter, And it's a variation of tall cabinet. It has four legs for stability. Still has some silver on the toes and the feet. And it's shops on Macassar Ebony, which was going to be the canvas, essentially, for this painting. The side is painted with this very intricate pattern and bold colors. And the idea was just, again, to explore this Cooper shape, how to build, at this point, as a designer, a complex curved shape, but very simply and lightly, by which I mean weight. So it's Cooper Cherry with this on the rear, and this facade of four doors rather on the front. And there's a lot of wonderful details when you open up the case. And there's no detail of it, but the top of this has got a band of mother of pearl. And as well as a designer, I'm trying to discover new materials or how to use materials that have been around for a long time effectively. This I can speak about because this is a fresh piece for me that's going to be sold at auction, I hope. It's a pair of cabinets. It's called Portman Starboard. I generally don't name my pieces, but this is one I have named. They're mirror images, and that's a very interesting problem to solve as a maker. How do you build something efficiently that's mirror images of each other? By which I mean you have joints that are right-handed and joints that are left-handed. So I tried to solve that. I won't go into that, but I tried to solve it efficiently. Again, the same Cooper shape as you saw in the last piece, which was called Baba Vienna. This was Douglas fir and rosewood, and my wife again has painted these panels, which have seagrass and gold leaf. So they're meant to evoke a seaside boat shape, shells, little beads that run between the staves, are proud of the staves. Simple forms in some way, like some door opening up, bow and handles, but I think that they're very evocative when they're together as a pair in terms of the imagery of the beautiful golden woods and this relationship to other things, as I said, boats and seashells and other forms. Thank you.